Is there any way we can check up on your assumptions? Asked Meredith anxiously. Confound it, Maxton. That sounds damnably rude of me, but it's a devilish important aspect of the case. Oh, you needn't study my professional feelings, laughed Maxton. I'm a pachyderm, and don't you forget it. And let me reassure you, we have two very good checks. First, an analysis of the liquid residue in the two glasses, as I mentioned before. Secondly, we could have an autopsy on both Mildman and the girl with a subsequent analysis of the stomach content. And once we're convinced that they drank a poison solution of equal strength, then we can fairly assume that they would have died within a minute of each other. Meredith turned to Rugby. What's your opinion, Rugby? I think we should press for an autopsy in both cases. If you like, and Maxton's agreeable, I'll get in touch with the coroner at once and arrange for the police ambulance to take the bodies to the mortuary. I should feel happier about my findings after an autopsy, said Maxton. Meredith rose. Good. That's settled, then. I leave you to make the arrangements. As a matter of fact, Rugby, I don't think it's fair of me to take up any more of your time. If you can send me over a good sergeant with local knowledge and a police car from County HQ tomorrow, that's all the help I shall need at present. Can do? Rugby nodded. Right. Tell him to report at the Leaning Man. 9 o'clock. On the dot. Chapter 16. Terence Through the Hoop. When Rugby and the police surgeon had left, Meredith sat for a good 10 minutes without the movement of an eyelid. He looked as if he were asleep, but mentally he had never been more alert. The case both interested and irritated him.